Thank you, and what beautiful, stirring tributes. Mr. President, America's First Lady, you honor us by being here. Governor, the Lieutenant Governor, the Attorney General are here. The two United States Senators are here. Congressman Flores, former Congressman Edwards, our State Senator is here. Our two State Representatives are here, and our two mayors. Mayor Duncan, here of Waco, and Mayor Muska of West. And if I may say so, perhaps above all, the people, the good citizens of West. America's great poet laureate, Robert Frost, wrote that good fences make good neighbors. Today there are no fences. From here on the banks of the Brazos, from Baylor University and its home city, the city of Waco, across the river to Belle Meade, to Lacey Lakeview, to Ross, to Elmont, over to Abbott, home of Willie Nelson, and then up to West itself. There are no fences because we're all together as neighbors. We're standing figuratively arm in arm, and it was a beautiful procession as people of West came in to this great arena, the Paul J. Meyer Arena at Baylor University, where we're accustomed to celebrating joyous graduations, victories on the court, earned championships. But today is a day of remembrance, a time to treasure one another and these great stories that we're hearing, stories about our neighbor. What powerful word that is. It's captured beautifully in a little book that we here in Waco read as a community in the project this past fall called One Book, One Waco. The name of the book, the title of the book, was Where Dreams Die Hard. It's a story about a little town near here and near West. It's called Penelope. And it's a small that people would ask, where's Penelope? And the response would be, why, it's east of West. But above all, this little book is a Tocquevillian book about neighbors loving one another. And here at Baylor, we know and love our neighboring community called West. We know its special places. We know that wonderful town center. We know the Village Bakery. We know the Little Czech Bakery. Travelers on the interstate on I-35 check in to the check-in. They know to stop by the check stop to get kolaches, not just for themselves, but for friends and neighbors. And we all love going across the river, heading to West for West Fest on Labor Day weekend. This is our community. It's a place of volunteers, as we now see so vividly and movingly before us, and as we hear and see on the screen, of those who come alongside us. And this is at the heart of who we strive to be and seek to do here at Baylor, through our own first responders, including volunteer firefighters in our student body. So we cannot restore these precious lives with their great stories that we have been hearing of volunteer firefighters and two other neighbors who made that ultimate sacrifice. And so we pay tribute instead on a day of remembrance here in our community of neighbors. And it's now my privilege to read a statement from the former president, President George W. Bush, who regrets that he was unable to be with us this afternoon. His words: "Today, we dedicated the new George W. Bush Presidential Center in Dallas. We are sad that we cannot be with you for this memorial service. We send our heartfelt sympathies to the citizens of West. All who are suffering are in our thoughts and prayers. Stay strong, and may God bless you." Let me say in closing that I was asked one business item. The City Council of West has been concerned about the sources of information, the flurry of information, the accuracy of the information, and so I've been asked by the City Council, and I'm pleased to do it, to set before you, the people of West, and those who love West as we all do, that the best source for information is the official city website, and that is www.cityofwest.com. God bless the City of West and these great neighbors. Thank you.